What's up guys, this is Tech Titanium, and in this video we are going to do some benchmarking in Modern Warfare 2, and I'm going to go over the NVIDIA Control Panel settings, and I just want to show you guys, currently my settings are at default. So under Global and Program Settings, if I show you where it's MW2 selected, this is also default, but I'm going to go ahead and restore this anyway for video purposes, and we'll talk some more about this after some clips.
Spotter activated.
Okay guys, so what's next? Next up, I'm going to open up NVIDIA Control Panel and I'm going to navigate over to Program Settings, because I only want these affecting Call of Duty. I don't want it interfering with any of my other games, because at the end of the day, this is a Call of Duty optimization, right? So I'm just going to be setting these off. I took a couple pictures of my phone. I did my research, I sampled a bunch of different recommendations, so I'm just going to go off based off some of the ones I've seen. So we're going to go ahead and turn off image scaling. Anisotropic filtering is application controlled. Gamma correction is set to on. Anti-aliasing mode is application controlled. Transparency, this is off. Max frame rate off. CUDA GPUs, I'm going to go ahead and select my graphics card. Based off a couple videos, I need to set this to ultra. Max frame rate off. I have a G-Sync monitor, so I'll select that. Select my graphics card under rendering GPU. And of course, we are going to want maximum performance, right? So preferred refresh rate, we're going to make sure that's on the highest available. Anisotropic sample optimization is off. Negative LOD is allow. The quality for the texture filtering is set to, where is it here? High performance. And threaded optimization is on. Triple buffering is off. Vertical sync is going to be off. And that is pretty much it, guys. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and apply these and do some more benchmarks and get back to you guys. Okay, guys, so I'm on the same map because I want the best possible accuracy when it comes to comparing all these settings. So I'm going to go ahead and continue what I did in the first three benchmarks. Okay guys, so here we have the recommended settings for the in-game graphics. So I'm just going to go ahead and cycle through these. And I'm going to perform the same benchmark test that I did prior. So there you have it, guys. That is some Modern Warfare 2 benchmarking with all original settings, including the control panel and, of course, the modified settings. I personally will not be using these settings as they reset every single time there's a graphics card driver update, and the gains are so small that it's just not worth it for me, and I don't really feel like changing that stuff every single time. I'm not too sure how this applies to older software and parts, of course, because we all have different computers. So this is something that you'll have to play around with yourself and see if the updates or modifications, are worth it for you. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I will be creating some more content in the days to come. So stay tuned. Have a good one, guys.